Boys and girls, welcome! We are starting a new series, and the way we're going to do it is it's going to be the Good Life Show. It's gonna be so exciting. Mr. Brandon is our host, and every week for the next 17 weeks, he's gonna have a guest come and talk to us. It's gonna be so amazing. I can't wait for you to see who the guests are. You're never going to believe all the people that are coming to talk to us at MSC Kids. We're so pumped. So it's going to be based on the Sermon on the Mount. Have you heard that before? Sermon on the Mount? It is one of the most famous sermons ever spoken by Jesus. And it is located at the Mount of the Beatitudes. It's in northern Israel, and it happens right after Jesus's baptism and when he invites the disciples to follow him. So cool. What a great time in history that this is coming to play, that we get to learn about the Sermon on the Mount all summer long. I can't wait for you to see what we have in store for you. Enjoy.
I want you as you are, not as you ought to be. Won't you lay down your guard and come to me? The shame that grips you now is crippling. It breaks my heart to see you suffering. 'Cause I am for you, I'm not against you. If you want, don't think you need to settle for a substitute when I'm the only love that changes you. And I am for you, I'm not against you. I am for you, I'm not against you. If you want,
I'm feeling good, good, good in a crazy way. God's love changed me more than I can say. Can't keep this in, gotta let it out. Gonna tell the whole world that your love is spinning me round and around. Yeah, it's turning me upside down. I can't believe the way you love me.
my bro Chachos. Well, guys, guess what? You are on the It's the Good Life Show. Hey, I'm Brandon. I'm your host. And for the next couple of weeks, we get to hear all about the Sermon on the Mount on It's the Good Life. Today, I have a special guest that's going to be joining us. It's my friend Evan. Give it up for Evan, everyone.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Oh, man. I'm so excited that you get to be on the show today.
Yeah.
So, Evan and friends, today we are looking at the first part of the Sermon on the Mount. This is the sermon that Jesus tells his disciples and his people how to live.
Yeah.
And so the first thing that we're going to be learning about is what it looks like to be poor in spirit. And my friend Evan, he has talked to me about this so many times, and he is the perfect guest for today. So, Evan, I'm not going to tell them. I want you to tell them.
Yeah.
What does it look like to be poor in spirit?
Well, that's a great question. And I'd love to show you a little bit, if that's okay. I found a box of things that I think is really important to you.
Wait, where'd you find that?
Oh, man, you don't even know.
No,
I think it was like, oh, man, look at that.
Oh,
is that
no,
really?
No,
oh, man, you love that? And,
okay.
And oh, whoa.
Mr. Quackerson.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
What about this thing?
Oh, no. Oh, this is my bunny.
Oh, man. Oh, this is big.
Yeah. Oh, there's my client.
Oh,
here.
Man. And look at that. That's awesome.
Hey.
Oh, goodness.
I won this one time at a carnival.
What?
Oh, no. Ah!
Oh.
Hey, why'd you throw bread at me?
That's a great question. Great question. Here's what the Bible says. It says that Jesus is the bread of life. And that we need him every single day. So in Matthew chapter 5, he tells his disciples and his followers that blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs will be the kingdom of heaven. But what does that mean? Such a great question. Well, as you saw, Brandon has a lot of things that he loves, a lot of interests, a lot of things that he's good at and
like
really
Quarkerson.
Interesting. Yeah. And I think we all do. You probably have lots of things that you love that you're really good at. Your parents, your friends have lots of things that they love and they're really good at. And this can be the struggle sometimes, is when we find something that is an interest, a skill, a hobby, it can become really important. And when it becomes really important, we can convince ourselves that this is what's really going to make us happy. And this is what's really going to bring us everything we want in life. And so what Jesus is saying is, yeah, we have things in life that make us happy, and they can create moments of happiness, but it is only him that can truly bring us joy in everything we truly want, the kingdom of God. Let's put it this way. I have a buddy who describes it like this, that one time he went to a carnival. Have you ever been to a carnival?
I have. Yeah, that's where I got Mr. Quackerson.
Whoa, no way.
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome. I've been to a carnival. They're a ton of fun. They've got rides and games and prizes.
And prizes.
Come on. It's so much fun. Well, my buddy says he went with a group of friends, and he didn't realize how expensive it was going to be. This was a carnival that cost money to get in. And then once you got in, it cost money to ride the rides and to play the games and to even get prizes. And he didn't realize how expensive it was going to be. So he paid to get in, but that was all his money. He didn't have any money left. And so he realized that once he was inside, the only way that he was going to be able to enjoy everything that was inside the carnival is if someone else covered the cost for him. So what
okay.
Jesus is saying in Matthew 5 is that we have things in life that are going to bring us happiness and joy. Does that bring you happiness?
So much happiness.
Oh, we have things that are going to bring us happiness, but they're just moments. And they're not going to be able to cover the entire cost of everything that is great. And Jesus says, I can cover that for you. And so people who recognize that, yeah, we have lots of good things, but they're not enough. I truly need something else. He says, I am that something else. And so for us that are covered in all of these things, if we don't have room to add Jesus into our life and to hear from him and to know him more, that happiness and that joy, it's going to remain fleeting. So that's why he says, blessed are the poor in spirit, the ones who recognize, I don't have enough. I need something else, for theirs will be the kingdom of God.
Oh, that's so awesome. So really, I don't even need Mr. Quackerson anymore.
Well, hold on. hold on. You can still have Mr. Crackersworth. Yeah, this is the cool thing about Jesus, is he's not saying get rid of all of this stuff. Like, I know some of you, you're probably really good at, you know, sports or video games or school. Jesus isn't saying you have to get rid of all of that to have him. He's just saying we need to make sure that we have space for him. Or even better, maybe we give everything we're good at to Jesus and say, I want to play sports for you. I want to do school for you and to help others know who you are.
That is so cool. Man, I even want to live that way in my life now. I hope you guys do too. Well, hey, thank you so much, Evan, for coming on. What an amazing story. It's really important for all of us, right? That by having that bread of life, by having Jesus in our life, that it's not that none of this matters anymore, but we don't need these things anymore because we have him.
Yeah.
And that's so cool that he pays our way, right? Well, boys and girls, if you want that bread of life, if you want Jesus to be your savior and to pay your way, then talk to one of your leaders. Talk to a parent. We would love to be able to have them talk with you and so that you can be part of this kingdom just like Evan and I. Well, Evan, I'm so glad that we got you on the show today.
Yeah.
And let's go make that into some garlic bread.
Oh,
and
come on.
We'll see you guys next week on It's the Good Life. Bye.
See ya.
What kind of love would stand in the flames and choose to remain there beside me? What kind of love would go to the grave, give up everything just to find me? Of all the treasure that this world could offer me, you're the only thing I need. Oh, no greater love, no greater love, no greater love than yours. No greater.
Hi guys, wasn't Evan and Brandon so funny? They were amazing. The dynamic of them together was so fun to watch. We learned about what poor in spirit means. Thank you, Evan, for coming and talking to us today. Next week, guess who's gonna be here? Oh, I'm not gonna tell you. You have to wait and see. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.